For sure, Dolphin is the best file manager on Linux. It is well configured by default. But you can improve its functionality, and I will show you how. Hello everyone, it's a Linux user, helping you to install, configure and use Linux. I make Linux tutorials every Wednesday and Friday. Subscribe and hit that bell notification so you won't miss any new video. Dolphin is a KDE file manager. And when I say that it is the best file manager on Linux, it's not just my opinion. This is what I hear from many other people in the Linux community. It is a great file manager indeed. It has enormous amount of features and I cannot cover them all in this video. So I will only show you how I configure Dolphin for my preference. This is how Dolphin looks on my system. If you don't have these default home directories, you can install the package xdg-user-dirs. So in this case I installed it for Arch Linux. Look for a similar package in your distribution, and after you install it you need to run this command. And this will create the default home directories. So I have done this already, that's why I have these folders here. Also, if you find annoying opening files and folders with a single click, you can deactivate it in the settings. You need to go to the settings, input devices, and here in the mouse you can disable single click and activate double click. I have already done this on my system. So now let's start configuring our file manager. The first thing I don't like is that these folders are not placed here in the places, so I don't have any shortcuts here. So the first thing I always do, I just copy these places here. After that, I added these icons, because by default you get the folders, but I prefer to have an icons. It is more pleasant visually and it is much easier to navigate. So for example, if you want to change the icon for your documents, you right click on this shortcut, go to edit, and here you click on this icon. Then you can select any icon you want. You can also use search here. And I select documents here. You see this is the icon, and now our documents have this icon. You can do the same for the other folders. For example, this is the download icon. And do this for the rest of the folders. You can also place any other icon here. For example, I often place my shared folder, because it's a virtual machine where I record it, so I have a shared folder which is sfpublic here, so I also copy it here. And the network we can move somewhere down, because I don't use network here. And for this folder again, we can edit it. You can also change the color of the folders if you want. For example, if you go to root, it's a red color now, but you can use, you know, yellow, for example. See, now it's a yellow color here. So this is the first thing I do. Now I have all the shortcuts here. So if I go to downloads, for example, I can quickly jump to my shared folder, for example. You can change the folder icons here as well. For example, public folder doesn't have any icon on it. Let's change it. Go to properties, click on the icon, search for public. Now public folder looks much better. I usually don't use template, so you can just hide it. You press F2 to rename it and you put the dot in front of it. So this will make this folder hidden. So now this panel is configured. Next we need to configure our tools. And the first thing I do, I disable the text. I use just icons here. I also like them to be a little bit larger than they are by default. So I use large. And then I go to the configure. And here I do the following changes. I remove the detail view. I also remove the find tool, because I use Ctrl F shortcut to search for files in Dolphin. I also remove split view, because I don't use it that often, and if I really need it, I can press F3 and I will get split view in Dolphin. And next I add some more tools here. The first tool I add is app, and I place it next to the navigation icons. Then I also add reload. I also use hidden files tool. Of course you can press Ctrl H for example, or Ctrl dot, and it will show you the hidden files, but I like to have this quick shortcut here. Next I add the trash icon, tab, and terminal. I rearrange the order. Then I press apply and I can see these tools here. If I like everything, I can click OK here. If I want to change something, I can do the changes here. But what I don't like, by default you get this trash icon, which is not very nice looking here. I prefer to have something like this contrast flat icon. So you go to the move to trash, and here you can change the icon. And you look for trash, and select this or this, depends what you like more. You apply, and you see the trash icon has changed. Now it fits the style of these icons. You can go for all these tools available on the left side and move them to the right, and then will be available in your Dolphin file manager. It's up to you what you like more. There are many useful things, but I don't use many of them. For example, you can use rename tool, but I usually press F2 to rename things. This is what I prefer. So I can show you what it does. For example, this changes the view. I think this is pretty obvious. If you click hidden files, it shows all the hidden folders and files. Preview will just show the preview. As you can see here, I disable it and then I enable it. If I press trash icon, it moves file to the trash. You can also tell it to move files to the trash without confirmation next time, because you don't delete the files, you just move them to the trash. If I go here, I can restore it. And I also like this terminal icon. If I navigate somewhere, for example, I downloaded some file and I want to process it with the terminal, I click here and the terminal opens in the downloads folder. I find it very useful. Of course, there are shortcuts for all these features and you can use them. For example, if you click F5, it will refresh the view. As I mentioned before, I think I'm more mouse person, so I just click here and it refreshes the view. So what it does when you created a new file somewhere and you don't see it listed, you can click refresh and the file will appear. And the last one, I think you all know that this is the menu which you can use. You can also go deeper into the settings of Dolphin and do a lot of changes here. But I usually keep things by default. I like to enable copy and move command. I don't use any Bluetooth here, so I can disable this one. I also don't use menu run in console, so I disable it too. I don't use activities, so I also disable this one. So it's up to you, you can choose what you prefer here, what you use or what you don't use. After that, click apply. You can also download new services. I have a separate video where I show different services for Dolphin File Manager. You can adjust the size of your trash, I keep it default. I also go to the preview and I enable some extra previews, so I make sure that the images preview are enabled, because I use a lot of images. You can enable font files preview too, it just adds extra beauty. I don't use many deja vu files, but I also sometimes use them, so I enable them. And I also like to have preview for SVG images and text files. I also usually disable calls in Dolphin with multiple tabs, because I use many tabs and I rarely accidentally close them. So when I want to close the Dolphin, I want to close all the tabs without any confirmation. It just saves some time. And if you want, you can also adjust your status bar. I don't use the zoom slider here, because I zoom by pressing Ctrl on my keyboard and then I scroll the wheel on my mouse. For example, like this. But I like to have this status bar about the free space on my computer. And the last thing I haven't showed you is the tab. So if you press the tab here, you can get multiple tabs in different places. For example, downloads, documents, my home folder, we can go to the video. And you see, you can quickly navigate between them. I find this very useful, I use these tabs most frequently. And if I close them here, usually you would get a confirmation. But if I close now, there won't be confirmation. Going back to the file previews, for example, now if you open Dolphin File Manager and navigate into the folder with images, you will see that not all the previews shown. For example, XCF file doesn't have a preview, but preview works for SVG and PNG. To fix that, you need to open Terminal and install this package. This is for Arch Linux. If you use any other distribution, go to the Software Manager and search for this package, install it, and after the installation, restart the Dolphin file manager, navigate to that folder again, and as you can see now, the preview for XCF file works. I hope you found something useful in this video, and maybe you will also configure your Dolphin file manager similar to mine. I would appreciate if you share in the comment section how you configure your Dolphin file manager. Is there any must-have feature you would recommend? Thank you for watching!